welcome to the Building Champions Conference. I'd like to have all the guys that come up here to the altar. We're going to open up in prayer. I want to do something different. If you could just have everyone come to the front here at the altar. And let's circle up in a circle right here. Welcome each individual here to this day as we have for this Builders Champions Conference of Men's Day. And let's go and open up some prayer right now. Father, we just thank you, oh God, for this morning, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for how you're going to be with all of us today, oh God. We thank you, God, for those that will come later in the day, oh God. And even as we hear at this altar, God, as we in here in this place of worship, oh God, that you, oh God, would open up the heavens, oh God. And that you would allow your men, oh God, to experience you like never before, God. Allow this altar, God, be a place of inhabitation, oh God, for your people, oh God. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We thank you, oh God, for every part of this service, oh God, on this morning, oh God. That you would touch the lives of your men, oh God. The priests, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for building champions, oh God, in this circle, oh God. That each man, oh God, when they walk away, oh God, from this altar, oh God, they will feel empowered, oh God, and know that you are with them, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for just the word that's going to come forth on today, oh God, that will speak to your men, oh God, that will speak to every aspect, oh God, and those that came here expecting something from you, oh God, that you would meet them, oh God, at their need, oh God. We just thank and we bless you, oh God, for taking us into a deeper place in you, oh God. We thank you, oh God, as champions, as men, oh God, that you would, oh God, remove those things that block us from entering in, oh God. And even as worship goes forth this morning, oh God, that there will be things, oh God, that you allow the words to penetrate the hearts of your men, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, we worship you, God. We bless you, Lord. And we as we clap our hands, we just thank you, Lord. Just as we are at a football game, we just thank you. We're going to thank God, our Most High God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for everything that you're going to do. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord, for this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
What you do, this is what you do. first time. Finally living for the first time. Sing it out. Living for the first time. Finally living for the first time. Come on. It's like a living for the first time. Finally living for the first time. Like I'm living for the first time. This is what you do, yeah. This is what you do. This is what you do. You made me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You made me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. You made me come alive. This is what you do. This is what you do. Oh, you made me come alive. You made me come alive.
I'm lifting up. Just the drums and the voices. My sin and my rejection met your love and my acceptance. Now I'm alive to bring you praise. Everyone sing it again.
You came to set the captives free. You came to bring us liberty. Rejection, your part and my acceptance. I'm alive to breathe. When the Spirit of the Lord is there is freedom.
Come on, champion, sing it out.
When the Spirit of the Lord is there is freedom.
Every
chain is broken through you, Jesus.
Your blood covers.
Your blood covers every sin.
In your grace, come on, and your grace empowers me to.
Your blood and my acceptance. Alive to breathe.
Lift him up.
When the Spirit of the Lord is there is freedom. When the Spirit of the Lord is there is freedom.
say, you can worship the Lord in your heart, but let me tell you this, the Bible is very clear that praise is an outward action. It's an outward action to the Lord. Now, I know we're all champions in this room, so I want us to do something for God. I want us all to clap our hands in unison. Like this, come on. This is an outward expression of our praise. This is an outward expression of our praise. Yes, it is. Lift your voice. Hey! All right, come on. Lift your voice. See, a couple people are exhausted already, but don't worry, the Lord is renewing strength. Come on. We're gonna praise the great I am in this place.
You are dancing and singing the
sink in.
You're the great I am.
You're the great I am.
Keep going.
The great I am. The great I am. The great I am. The great I am.
Because you are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good.
Let those words sink in. Receive the revelation of those words.
You're rejoicing over me. You are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good daddy. You're rejoicing over me.
This song, I have to work too hard. So, when he started saying that you are a good, good father, you're a good, good daddy, here's what I heard. How can they believe me if they're too busy with their daddy hang-ups? Now, I know all of us are men in this room. Looks like not too many, I don't see any boys. And I'm saying that for a reason. Because no matter how grown you are, there's still a boy that went through some things with his dad. I told my dad I love him. His response was, uh-huh. I said, finally I said, well, I'm grown up enough to ask him a question. Dad, what's that all about? He said, well, we didn't really do that in my day, son. And I said, well, seems kind of odd that you can't just express your feelings. And here's something I want to say. Our lack of being able to express because of what we've seen modeled gives us inability to express to our Heavenly Father. The model isn't your earthly father. The model is your Heavenly Father, who was great in expression. When he sent his son to say, this is how much value you have, my child, my son. This is how much value you have. This is how much I care for you. This is how much I love you. Why are you going to let what he couldn't say, hang up what I say? And this is the reason why it's good. It's so important, because once you know you're loved, and then you learn how good he is. If your child asks for a rock, and this is what I was really hearing, there's some people with some superior ideas in this room, like world-changing ideas in this room. And the facts are that if you don't know how much you're loved, and you don't know how good he is, then when he says something like, hey, if your child asked you for a rock and you wouldn't give him bread, and if your child asked for a fish, you wouldn't give him a serpent, if you wouldn't do that, you being evil, how much better is your Heavenly Father, and how much more is he going to give? And so his heart is exposed through these parables that says, those award-winning ideas, those things that you're afraid to get out on the waters. See, it's not good to get out on the waters if you don't know he's good, because you're going to sink. So we're just going to chant this as a, like, as a renewing of our minds, that you are a good, good father. Just real chill like you got going on there. You are Jesus.
Father, you are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good daddy. You're rejoicing over me. You are a good, good daddy. You are a good, good daddy.
on, you feel that cleansing. That's a cleansing, the washing of the water, the word. God just restoring, God's redeeming. Come on, just let down the walls and just dive in with your Father. This is your time to know that you are cared for, you are watched over. God is ordering your steps, and you're going to see His delight over your life as you trust in the Lord with all your heart. And you lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways you acknowledge Him. He's directing paths right now. Come on, He's bringing straightness to your path. Hey, you are good.
Christians by our love,
all together now.
We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. And we thank you, Lord, our unity has finally been restored. Yes, they'll know we are Christians.
Sing it again.
By our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
What God has put together, what God has put together, let no man separate it. What God has put together, let no man separate it.
What God has put together, let no man separate it. What God has put together, let no man separate it.
Just the voices.
What God has put together, let no man separate.
Even the musicians, sing that out.
What God has put together, let no man separate it.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord.
Come on.
How many of you enjoy Jeremy? How many of you enjoy Jeremy, our worship leader? Jeremy is absolutely amazing. And if you knew his story about how Jeremy came, I just want to give honor where honor is due. That's what the Bible tells us to do, correct? Jeremy is a young man of God that has a hunger that I've never seen in somebody to lead worship and a passion to be able to take men to the thing. And Jeremy, I just want to give you this word the Lord gave me is that he's making you a Nehemiah. That he wants you to build things that were once built. He wants you to go back into that city and restore exactly what has happened in your community. And the lives of men that think that they don't matter because of where they came from, God said he's going to use you, Jeremy, to be able to restore them and build back their city in the name of Jesus. And I believe God's corporately calling us all to be Nehemiahs today. Amen. He's calling the game changers, the world changers, the priests of their households, the men, the brothers, the husbands, for every one of us to stand up like mighty men of valor. Put the weight capacity on your shoulders and be the man of your house today and stand up and let God build you a champion. Let me see the hands of some champions in this place this morning. Give God a cry. Tell him your war cry this morning. Say, God, make me a champion. Make me a man of God in this place today. Come on, somebody. That's not enough. I'm going to tell you right now. Y'all are going to go home and tell your wife that says, I'm glad you didn't come. Because what God's going to impart in you today and the man of God that's here to speak this word to you today, all day long God is going to fill you up and you're going to go home and you're going to love better and you're going to build better and you're going to be better and you're going to drive better. You're going to work better. In the marketplace, they're going to say, what happened to you? You're going to say, God made me a champion. God made me a champion this weekend. Hallelujah. Come on. I think they might have gave the wrong one a microphone this morning, Brass Pastor Tony. If you guys could find your way to your seats this morning, we're going to transition into taking up the offering. Wow.